welcome to another episode of Dark Skies Podcast, coming to you live from Los Angeles. Yes, once again, it's here to chop it up with y'all. So I'm going to give you a second to make yourselves comfortable, get yourselves adjusted, light them if you got them, and we'll be back in a few seconds. Today we're talking Los Angeles. Man, it's kind of crazy here. All right, we'll be right back. Good morning. Thank y'all for joining us. Right now, the city fired up. Everybody fired up. Everybody fired up. I'm going to let you know why. You're listening to Dark Skies Podcast, coming to you live from Los Angeles, from the Bay to LA, all the way to San Jose, up to Sacramento, down to San Diego, all the way to the East Coast. What's up, Virginia? What's up, New York? Hey. Carolinas, all the way to Georgia, and all my friends down in Florida, all the way across the pond. What's up, UK, France? Nice to see y'all joining us. Right above our heads, I see you, Canada. Always beautiful to have you. But today we're talking Los Angeles. Man. My eyes are like heavy because I've been up all night. Had to work. Then, you know, the Dodgers. Oh, man, the Dodgers. Woo! Well, if you live here in L.A., you know exactly what I'm talking about. We are all just, trying to snap out of it. The euphoria. Fall classic, baby. But without further ado, we're going to get the show started. I know I'm a little fired up. First of all, I'm your host, LC Graves. Thank you. Mikey Knight's in the building. Jen over here helping out the sound levels. Jennifer on the ones and twos. I see you over there, Becky. You going to be helping? So this weekend, everybody's fired up. Everybody's talking about last night. Last night, man, I was jumping. Okay, we're talking Dodger Stadium, right? And, World Series. And I was mad. I ain't gonna lie, y'all, it was a frustrating game to watch. You know, after the kid, Walker Buehler, you know, he pitched a gem. Had us in position to win the game. Left the game, 1-0. Gave us some strong innings. Was getting some strikeouts. Actually was pitching strong, you know, when we was just before we pulled him out. And, you know, for a pinch hitter, and they're going to use Kenley Jansen. Now, Kenley is our closer, but they were going to use him for 2 innings. You know, we need you to get 6 outs, Kenley. And the crowd was pumped. And I hate to set the scene, but let me just set the scene. Everybody's fired up because we're up 1-0. Kenley comes in and, you know, he's going to get the last 6 outs for us. And some of us is kind of, you know, fired up because, you know, Kenley's the man. Kenley going to get these outs, right? So Kenley Jansen come in, right, and gets the first out. Crowd go crazy. Right. Gets the second out. Crowd go crazy. Next guy. Yuck. Man. I think that ball's still flying. Anyway. Tie ball game. You know, that easy. So now, you know, I gotta go to work at this point, so I'm like, oh man. You know, the game's tied. you know, all the energy's been sucked out of the stadium. Everybody was, you know, just like, oh my God, I can't believe this just happened. You know, we just watched this kid. Probably could have pitched a complete game shutout if we would have just left him in. And we took him out for, you know, for a pinch hit at bat that didn't produce nothing. So that hurts too. It's like, man, you could have just left him in if he was going to. Well, I think they brought Matt Kemp in or somebody and he didn't do shit. But anyway, man, this is baseball, though. You know, you play the numbers, and the Dodgers are known for playing the numbers. So anyway, I had to work, and I think by the time I make it to work or whatever, you know, it was like 2-1 or whatever. And I was like, oh my God, you know, we're going to lose. You know, we down 2-1. You know, so we ain't showing no ability to get hits, string, move no batters. I mean, you know, move the runner along. You know, we're not playing small ball. And this is like the Dodger rant, right? You know, it's like, 'cause I'm feeling bad. You know, like, oh my God, we're finna go down, you know, 0-3. So, man, it's so crazy. But anyway, eventually, you know, the Dodgers tied, but at this point, I'm at work, so I'm missing all of this. So, you know, it was a quick shift. You know, I'm covering for somebody. Don't know why, because it's, you know, it's the World Series. I should have been watching the World Series, but instead, you know, I'm covering for a friend. Anyway, that's a different story, different day. So, there, and I'm, you know, finishing up. And I'm getting ready to head over to the studio so we could work on the show for today. And the game was still going. And I was like, you know, this has got to be a replay, right? Are they replaying the game? And no, it was the game. And that was crazy. I was like, I can't believe this, man. You know, it's still going on. I think by this time it was like the 14th inning or something like that. I think I get to listen to the 14th and the 15th. But anyway, it was just incredible that the game was still going on by the time, you know, I had get off work and was, you know, heading over to the studio. So we were trying to watch the game and get ready for the show, but man, all the people, everybody was still up, everybody. So, you know, it ended up being like just a big conversation, you know, because people were staring at the TV. You know, people were saying, oh, Matt Muncy almost hit a home run, but it just went foul. I mean, it just went foul. And I was like, dang. You know, so you could just hear the frustration, you know, in people's voice. I mean, Mikey and them was like, man, this is crazy, man. I know. But we was like, this is not real. So we're looking at the game, and Matt Muncy comes up again. And we were thinking, like, they said he almost hit a home run. I was at work, so I didn't see it. And on my way home, I listened to the game. But I don't think that happened during the time when I was listening. Anyway, by the time we was watching it, you know, man, this man cracked the home run. And everybody went crazy. Fireworks started going up. The stadium went crazy. The media, the fans. I mean, it was almost like they won game 7. I mean, everybody was fired up. I mean, drinks all around. Everybody was turning up. I mean, light them if you got them. But yeah, I mean, everybody was so happy to win that game. That game was so long. And they were saying it was one of the longest games in championship history, if it's not the longest. I mean, by hours, I mean, there may have been games that were longer by innings, but that game took, what was it, 6 or 7 hours? You know, that game was going forever. I'm telling y'all. But the doctors pulled it out. And that's amazing because, man, going down 0-3, I meant that the World Series had probably been over. But it's not. And now, I mean, everybody's fired up, man. We're getting ready for game two. So, man, gonna keep it going. Hopefully tie the World Series up. But this is crazy, man. We're talking Los Angeles. Listening to Dark Skies Podcast live from Los Angeles, California. Ooh, it's crazy. And she got ass, and she gon' fuck up a bag. Pull up to the spot, living too fast. Dropping the dope in the stash. In Italy, got two foreign hoes, they DM me. Drop the top, when it's cold, but you feel the heat. Be real with me, keep it 100, just be real with me. Eat it up like it's a feast. They say the dope on fleek. Percocet pill on me, I saw my neck, baby, chill with me. Them niggas that fucked in the back don't say nothing, them niggas are kill for me. Back as I count in my sleep, on fleek. 100K spent on that patty for leak. Bitch, I'm a dog in my tree. Hop out the frog and leap. I put them bricks in the fender. My bitch, she walk around like she Chris Jenner. I used to break in the Emma, then take up running like the game of Temple. It's simple, I play with a mantle. Mama say she saw me on Jimmy Kimmel. Canada, cause I'm a money symbol. Walking with these rats, I'm looking crippled. Fuck on that bitch, then I temple. A nickel for me to take pictures. Not from LA, but I clip her. Double my cup or a triple. Fox on my body, no biblical. I'm not your average or typical. Look at my wrist and it's critical. Hold it up, dropping the temperature. I get that bag on the regular. I got a bag on my cellular. Back in the bag of them vegetables. Bag of them cookies, it's medical. Cocaine, codeine, etc. Cocaine and lean is federal. I take off landing on Nebula. As an that's when the M's on my schedule. Take off. You get the bag and fumble it. I get the bag and flip it and tumble it. Straight off the lot, 300 cash. And the car came with a blunt in it. Lil' mama a thot, and she got ass. And she gon' fuck up a bag. Pull up to the spot, living too fast. Dropping the dope in the stash. In Italy, got two foreign hoes, they DM me. Draw at the top, when it's cold, but you feel the heat. Be real with me, keep it 100, just be real with me. Eat it up like it's a feast. They say the dope on fleek. I know that these niggas getting sick of me. These chains on my neck cause a meal a piece. I don't even like to freestyle for free. I put in the key and I ride the beat. I don't even come out the house for free. I pay a nigga to drive for me. Jay-Z couldn't even co-sign for me. I do what I want cause I'm signed to me. I get the back. They get the back, have to cut it in half. Stop the comparing, y'all making me laugh. Need to rehab, I'm addicted to cash. Convertible walk, convertible top. My dope got a vertical, look at it how. And it jump out the pot. Came out the jail and went straight to the top. Take it easy, baby. Middle of summer, I'm freezing, baby. Don't leave me, baby. Just drop to your knees and please me, baby. I'm fascinated. Two bitches so fine that I masturbated. Congratulations. She bring me so good that I graduated. They had to hate it. I don't fuck with them niggas, they plastic, baby. A trapper, baby. I rap, but I own all my masters, baby. It's tragic, baby. I pull up and fuck up the traffic, baby. A savage, baby. I'm killing these niggas, close casket, baby. You get the bag and fumble it. I get the bag and flip it and tumble it. Straight off the lot, 300 cash. And the car came with a blunt in it. Lil' mama a thot, and she got ass. And she gon' fuck up a bag. Pull up to the spot, living too fast. Dropping the dope in the stash. In Italy, got two foreign hoes, they DM me. Draw at the top, when it's cold, but you feel the heat. Be real with me, keep it 100, just be real with me. Eat it up like it's a feast. They say the dope on fleek. Woo, making Boston not feel welcome. Yes, Red Sox up all night, but not in the city. On the field, man, game was crazy last night. Ooh, hey, it's like one of the longest games, if not the longest game, man, in just Major League history, man. Come on. And our boys put in work. I guess they're saying, if you're going to put us out, man, you're going to have to take the long route, man. We ain't going out easy. We are not going out easy. But I tell you what, between them, as in the Dodgers, and the Lakers, yes, the Lakers have been, the story of the town. As LeBron James and, the young Lakers squad continues to try to hang in there while the suspensions of Rondo and Brandon Ingram, you know, are fulfilled. But anyway, during this time, everybody was expecting the Lakers to lose pretty much every single game and pretty much fall out of any type of playoff contention early in the season, or at least put themselves in a position where they would have to win so many games late in the season just to be in the conversation, just for the eighth seed. Now, okay, we're not really going to get into what people think versus what's actually happening, or should we? Because think about it, folks. Everybody says, okay, the Lakers don't have a chance. You know, LeBron is by himself. LeBron by himself in the West. You know, you just say all these different things, right? So everybody has an opinion. But nobody has an opinion that, hey, LeBron on any team in any conference is a threat. And if you're telling me that they're going to go 0-5, 0-6, 0-7, it was all kinds of crazy numbers coming out, especially right after the suspensions. And, you know, we laughed it off. Because it was funny. We didn't think that, you know, the Lakers would lose 7-8 and not win any games. You know, everybody going to beat the Lakers. You know, y'all going to be 0-3. And we were at that moment. They were like, well, y'all going to be 0-4, 0-5. Look at the people that are coming up, 0-6, 0-7. They were just counting the losses. Y'all going to be 0, you know. And I'm like, I don't know, man. I'm like, we still got LeBron. He didn't get suspended. I'm like, we're going to win some games. Y'all act like we just boo-boo. And they're like, well, y'all are. You know, y'all the boo-boo Lakers. And I'm like, wow. It's crazy, man, you know, the type of reputation that you get because everybody looking up to the Clippers, right? Oh, the Clippers is great. The Clippers are so wonderful. And I'm like, wow, okay. So we're just going to continue to fly under the radar. But then the Lakers win a couple of games, you know, and won against the number one team in the so-called conference, the Denver Nuggets, right? Denver Nuggets ran us off the floor a couple of times in the preseason. But then when they played us, when the money was on the table, what happened? You know, the Lakers went on and broke them down. And at that point, Denver had lost to nobody. You know, they had beat everybody, including Golden State. Now, Denver went from first to third in the conference. Of course, they 4-1. 4-1 is a beautiful record. But the team they beat, you know, Golden State is 5-1, so they number two in the conference. With New Orleans, do you believe that the New Orleans Pelicans are 4-0 in the Western Conference? And that, you know, they're number one up top. But even more surprising is the team at the bottom. Or should I say teams at the bottom of the Western Conference? And I ain't even talking about the Lakers because they told us we're going to be 0-7, 0-6, 0-7. Well, the Lakers are 2-3. And that's without Brandon Ingram and Rajon Rondo, right? So we was 0-3. Now we're 2-3. Anyway, let's talk about the bottom of the Western Conference, where presides the doormats of the Western Conference. The losers, the tankers. We're talking about the guys who's going to be at the top of the draft. And it's funny because it's some pretty good teams that were supposed to be contending for not just number 1, 2, 3, 4 in the West, maybe even to challenge Golden State, you know, and dethrone the champs. But you're not going to dethrone the champs, OKC, if you 0-4. That's 0-4, y'all. OKC. That's the Thunder where Paul George decided to you know what, I'm going to stay here. You know, I'm not even going to give the Los Angeles Lakers and Magic Johnson a meeting. I'm not even going to answer the phone. I don't even want to see L.A. I'm not going there. I'm going to kick it here and go fishing with Westbrook. We're going to chill. We're going to have a party. We're going to chill here in OKC. Well, I think they still having that party. And I think they still out fishing in OKC because, you know, how you going to start off 0-4? Yeah, I ain't got no suspensions. Is Westbrook suspended? No. They said he's playing. Yeah, he's playing. Said he was banged up. How many games he missed? Four? No, one. One. So how many games did George miss? None? So why are they 0-4? Yeah, it looked like y'all got a beautiful connection there. And y'all definitely got a good chance to dethrone the champs with that 0-4 record. You know, that puts you out of the picture, right? You're out of the picture. New Orleans Pelicans, 4-0. OKC, 0-4. Big difference. Now, if you want to ask me, Paul George, let me ask me, Paul George. You know, who would I rather play for? The 0-4 OKC, and that's the no thunder? You know, because there's no weather there right now. There's no thunder. Or do you want to play for the Los Angeles Lakers? You know, the Los Angeles Lakers got LeBron James. OKC got, you know, Westbrook, you know, and George. You know, LeBron James by himself, right? Oh, he not going to do nothing. The Lakers must be just here to make movies. Yeah, who would you rather be, 2-3, with players coming back from suspension, ready to try to make a run, get better throughout the season? Or do you want to be OKC, who Paul George and Westbrook played together last year? You know, so it's not like, oh, we need some games to get our continuity together. You know, we got to get our chemistry right? Or maybe OKC spent so much money on Paul George and Westbrook that the rest of the team is boo-boo. That's why you 0-4. But right above you is another surprise. And I'm not talking about the Phoenix Suns. The Phoenix Suns is above the team that's above you. The team that's above OKC at the bottom, another doormat of the Western Conference, is a team that's looking to make a trade. A team that we thought was stacked. How do you go from number one in the Western Conference last year, Houston, to a doormat of the Western Conference at 1-4? With your only win coming against the Lakers that the refs cheated and helped you win and threw out and suspended, and you had to fight. You had to do all kinds of dirty stuff to get that one win. One win. You know, that's like Iron Man and all the stuff he did to Thanos. He kicked him and like punched him and shot him and did all that stuff, and then Thanos just looked and said, all that for a drop of blood. All that for one win. Well, y'all take that one win. Might be the only win y'all get this year. Houston, y'all suck. Y'all went from number one. Y'all had James Harden, Chris Paul. You know, I had Trevor Ariza. You don't have him no more, right? You downgraded with Carmelo Anthony. You know, no D Anthony and no D'Antoni. You know, no D in his offense. Yeah, y'all all working good. So y'all 1-4 to start the season. So congratulations. And y'all lost to the Clippers and made them 3-2. So they feeling good about themselves because they beat up on y'all. Just like everybody else do. Like we was if the refs didn't save you. So we beat you up personally. I'm just playing. Anyway, people keep telling me, oh, Rondo spit in his face. Ah, I don't want to hear that. I'm tired of that subject. I'm tired of the story. I'm tired of it. I'm tired of hearing Chris Paul whine. You saved your two games. You back. Your team still suck. Y'all better make that trade. But you're making a trade with another team, Minnesota, who suck. y'all playoff teams, right, from last year, y'all down at the bottom. Y'all out of the playoffs right now. Houston, OKC, Minnesota. You're 2-4, Minnesota. So all of y'all, boo-boo. So I want to hear about the Lakers going 0-7. Anyway, Lakers getting stronger. Tonight, Rondo come back. San Antonio on the list, 2-2. So they finna get knocked out. Because we got a score to settle with them anyway. So San Antonio definitely going down. And I don't know, y'all. It's just funny. When I look at the numbers and the numbers that I see. But the Lakers are looking good. They 2-3. I know y'all saying that's a losing record. But fine. You just need to get your young players back. You need to get your team fully back. You need to work on your chemistry. You need to, you know, keep this momentum moving forward. And a lot of people, you know, can hate. Let them hate. You know, they've been hating on the Lakers for a long time. But it's a difference, you know. It's a long season. But the name of the game is to be the last motherfucker breathing. Trying to win the championship, baby. So, let's do it. L.A. live. Stress. Bust the freak in the knees. Give me reason to be the last motherfucker breathing. Bust my automatic rounds. Catch them while they sleeping. Now I'm the last motherfucker breathing. Stress. I bust the freak in the knees. Give me reason to be the last motherfucker breathing. Bust my automatic rounds. Catch them while they sleeping. Now I'm the last motherfucker breathing. Woke up with 50 enemies plotting my death. All 50 seeing visions of me shot in the chest. Couldn't rest, nah, nigga, I was stressed. Had me creeping round corners, homie sleeping in my vest. Shit, I'm like a hostage on this trouble block. Call the cops, a thug nigga screaming west side. Bustin' double glocks, hitting corners in my Chevy Suburban. Liquor got me driving up on the curb, hand on the steering wheel. Swerving, bless me, father, I'm a sinner. I'm living in hell, just let me live on the street. Cause ain't no peace for me in jail. Getting worldwide exposure. With a bunch of niggas that don't give a fuck. Riding as my soldiers, I'm just releasing on the warpath. Not your average dealer, west side outlaw, bad boy killer. Complete my mission, my competition, no longer beefing. I murdered all them busters, now I'm the last motherfucker straight. A buster free, enemies give me reason to be the last motherfucker breathing. Busting my automatic rounds, catch them while they sleeping. Now I'm the last motherfucker
breathing. Make sure I hold my position, stand firm in the dirt. All my soldiers gone, we burning the earth. Outlaws worldwide, we pack the block. Shooting rocks at the kid ops, bust back for pop. Ass shot, here tell you that it's hell down here. Stale down here, too many jails down here. Why you act like you don't hear me? Young noble outlaw, till these motherfuckers kill me, I'm still
we was raised, fuck this life. My role's my right, holding on a tight grip with death in my sight. And the dark is my light, I'm cynical. Sleepwalking isn't true, walk around town with a pair feeling pitiful. Came a long way from a poor day, dead away with his foreplay. Fuck friends, I'll say, rather die for my AK with these fag ass niggas. See through glass ass niggas, only ride my dick and get him a mash ass niggas. Please,
but bust the freak in the meat. Give me reason to be the last motherfucker breathe. Bust my automatic rounds, catch them while they sleeping. Now I'm the last motherfucker breathe.
I walk around with a knife in my back. Talk about a bad day, I live a life like that. It's severe, and I'm losing my hair. Bless a hooligan, catch me, I'm falling out flat. Yo, I'm ruining, breathing in suicide. No one give a fuck about me. I learned to like it like that when I was still in mommy. This not a city that the devil run from. In the belly of the beast, that's where the fuck we come from.
Instead of totally wasted, they want me to face this. Just lost two of my coaches, man, one of y'all can take this. But I'm back in belly drain, simple and plain. We number one, motherfucker, about to do it again. Shit, Pac still doing it, you hoes can't do it. 2 million every time he drop, I know you fuckers losing it. We moving it, throw the kill for a meal. Hold it still, hold the wheel. I'm about to get this nigga something, make him feel, make him real. But we the raw on the cut, style fighting thug line niggas. Give it up, we hit him up.
Last motherfuckers breathing, stress, but bust the freak enemies. Give me reason to be the last motherfucker breathe. Bust my automatic rounds, catch them while they sleeping. Now I'm the last motherfucker breathing,
free. Enemies give me reason to be the last motherfucker breathing. Bustin' my automatic rounds, catch them while they sleeping. Now I'm the last motherfucker breathing.
Who's gonna be the next to bring a championship to LA? I know times are hard right now. I know, people. I know. It's been a long time. People in LA going through some stuff. You know, bills are due. It costs a lot here. The traffic suck. The weather, you know, is good, only for some. Only if you got money to enjoy it. It's a lot of stuff going on here to make it hard, man. Hard. So people get it bad. You know, times are tough here in Los Angeles. Everybody not doing good, right? But one thing that it seems to always bring us together, it's when one of our teams bring a title home. Who gonna be the first to do it? I don't know, man. I don't know. I don't know. I tell you one thing. We got some people. We got the Dodgers in the championship right now. A lot of people were saying that it was over. Down 0-2. Coming back westward. You know? Got a kid pitching. Not looking good. Kershaw. Wow. Kenny Jansen. Wow. Every batter we got. Wow. It's just not looking good. Then next thing you know, you see a wheel. You know, a wheel that needs to be displayed if you're going to partake on a journey. As such, you know, you have to have a will unlike any other. And I've seen that in the Dodgers. Now, I don't know if they're going to win it this year, but I do know inside of them beats a champion's heart. Boston, built to win the championship. The best team that money can buy. They got bats, they got defense, they got pitching, they got coaching. They got front office. They got money. They got it all. They got the evil empire on their side. And we understand. Usually, when we win, we got to win against all odds. And that's what the Dodgers have to do. They have to win against all odds. They're going to have to find some kind of way to, man, push through. Now, winning game number 4. Well, that should be the number one thing on their mind. But it's hard because game 3 was so epic. It was like an epic journey. Okay, we got to break this team streak. Just like when you was playing Milwaukee and they were like beating up on everybody and it was on the long winning streak and they had 12 games or something like that. That's beating people's ass in baseball. You don't just beat like 10, 12 people. Or 10 to 12 games in a row. That means, you just whooping people's ass. It ain't nothing they can do. You know, because you only got one ace and he ain't pitching 12 times in a row. So that means you got a staff. You know, you got bats. You got a squad. You know, so the Dodgers had to, you know, break that somehow. And they did. And after that, they were able to fight their way past Milwaukee. Now, I'm not saying that the same method is being applied right here, where you just ran a team out with your depth, with your will, your heart, your desire. And then you snatch the victory out of the jaws of defeat. At least that's what they're hoping to do. I mean, we got game 4 coming up. We got the Dodgers. We got, man, the General, Rich Hill. So we got everybody in L.A. biting their fingernails. You know, Boston is a worthy adversary. Very scary to look across the field and see that team biting at the bits. And especially you know, playing in Boston. Man, how do y'all play in Boston? Oh, my God. That shit is crazy, man. It's cold. It's cold. It's cold. I guess that's why the Patriots do so well. And y'all greedy there. Y'all greedy. Y'all got the Celtics, right? Y'all got the Celtics. Y'all got the Patriots, right? Man, now y'all trying to do it with the Red Sox? See, that's why the world needs Los Angeles. And we live from Los Angeles. But yeah, the world needs Los Angeles to fight off Boston. If we don't fight off Boston, they'll be like the Boston Red Sox will be like the Patriots of the NFL and the Celtics of the NBA, and they'll rule all sports. And every year we have to see a parade in Boston. And no, we got to stop that. We'd rather see a parade here in L.A. So, man, you got the Rams trying to bring home the title. You got the Dodgers trying to bring home a title. You got the Lakers trying to fight for a title. You got the Clippers. Well, we got the Clippers. The Chargers. I mean, it's crazy, people. It's crazy. You listen to the Dark Skies Podcast coming to you live from Los Angeles, California, from the Bay to L.A. I'm telling y'all, man, it's crazy in Los Angeles right now. Man, we're scrapping for a title. Man, it keeps being Boston. Every sport, every time you look, it's Boston. Tied it. Gotta beat them.
I took water, water, soul, and bottles for $2 for Coca-Cola, came and bought it for fans. What the fuck? Have a baby by me, baby. Be a millionaire, I write the check before the baby comes. Who the fuck cares? I'm stanky rich. I'ma die trying to spin this shit. Southside's up in this bitch. Yeah, I smell like the boat. I used to sell dope. I did play the block, now I play on boats. In the south of France, baby. Sandro paid, get a tan. I'm already black. Rich, I'm already that. Gangster, get a gang. Hit a head in the hat. Call that a little rap shit. Fuck the chit chat. The big guy, bake the bread. A barber, I cut your head. A marksman, I spray the lead. I blood clot chocolate. Not fuck with the kid. I get biz with the cig. I can really live. You dig? I get it. Yeah. I run New York. I get it. I get it. Yeah, yeah. You can call this my new shit, but it ain't new though. I got rid of my old bitch, now I got new hoes. First it was the Benzo, now I'm in the Enzo. Ferrari, I'm sorry, I keep blowing up. They call me the cake man, the strawberry shake man. I spread AR, make your whole clique break dance. Backspin, head spin, flatline, you're dead then. Nine shells, matching. Who wanna get it cracking? I was young, I couldn't do good. Now I can't do bad. I ride back the new Jag, I just bought a new Jag. Now nigga, why you mad? Oh, you can't do that? I'm so forgetful. They calling me cocky. I come about the jeweler, they calling me Rocky. It's the ice on my neck, man. The wrist in my left hand. Bling like blow, you like my style. I'm headed to the bank right now. I get it. Yeah. I run New York. I get it. I get it. Yeah, I run New York.
Yeah, I talk the talk, and I walk the walk. Like a Teflon dog, boy, I run New York. When I come out of court, yeah, I pop the car. I keep it gangsta, how y'all London talk.
I get it.
In the hood, if you ask about me, they tell you I'm about my boy.
I get it.
Run the world, if you ask about me, they tell you they love you.
I get it.
Yeah,
I run New York. I get it. I get it.
Yeah,
I run New York. I'm back on the streets, man.
Yeah, we killing it. And that's from Word on the Street, Compton, Watts, Inglewood. You know what I'm saying? Man, San Pedro. I love y'all too, man. Hey. This is what we do. We get money, we get attention, we get ratings, we push hard, we still street, and we still cover everything. Man, how can we be so urban and so street, but still got much love in the scientific communities and the government communities? I mean, all over the world. Wow. You know why? Because we real. Don't come at you fake. Just let you know how we feel about what we feel when we feel it. Don't hold back, right? Well, that's what we do. We're not holding back. We're giving you the real. And the real is, right now in Los Angeles, things is crazy. We already know that. Times are hard for some. Some are working hard. Some are banking hard. We see big money coming in. We see stadiums being built. We see big, giant, massive hotels. We see industry moving in. So we know that there's money, infrastructure being, you know, replaced and replenished in city beautification projects going on. We know that. We know the Olympics is coming. We see all of these things. Venues are being created. So it is what it is. It's money, 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 money. So, yeah, we in on all of that. But, man, what's really going on? You know, this city has a heartbeat, right? This is more than just a city. This is a mega city. And I always tell people that. There's so many people here that you can't count them. Don't even know how many people here. And it's been like that for a long time. I'm telling you, it's been like that a long time. We don't know how many people are here. I mean, fuck the census. The census has been real. It's been wrong. It's been lost. You can't count people when people are hiding from you. It is what it is. So anyway, this is a mega city. So mega cities have mega city problems. And, you know, you got all kinds of crazy stuff going on. And word on the street, you know, we are the streets, right? We're the streets. You know, I'm from Compton. 90% of my connects are from the streets, got roots in the streets, you know, from every area, you know what I mean? From the SAs to the brothers, all the way to South Central. Man, stop. But anyway, it's more than that, y'all. It's more than just connecting on the streets. It's connecting on the ground level. It's connecting to the people inside these buildings, these managers, these corporate level execs. We're talking to everybody, man. Everybody seems to be interested in the things that we cover here on Dark Skies Podcast. And I love that, you know. And at the same time, it allows us to continue to still be, you know, what we are. And what I am is just a young black man from Compton that just has the knowledge of the stars. I don't know why. I don't know why I have this knowledge and why I'm cursed with this ability. But I share it. I don't keep it back. You know, I don't go hide in the room. Like, you know, I'm so smart, I don't want to tell anybody. No. And at the same time, I don't claim to be a genius. You know, I work with other people who could easily claim to be geniuses. But it's beautiful. You know, when you see the connection and the chemistry of so many different people from so many different backgrounds connected to so many different areas coming here, Dark Skies Podcast. You know, Mandela Effect Community. It is what it is. I mean, whole world seems to connect. And that's what I do. I connect universes. And I have fun doing it. And my base is right here in Los Angeles. That's why this show today, live from Los Angeles. Because I say it all the time, and I hear people start to say it because they're feeling us. And I guess that's their way of giving it up to us. Hey, live from Los Angeles. Anyway, live from Los Angeles. LC Gray's Dark Skies Podcast. Hey, they keep telling me that we're the hottest podcast, right? We already know that. They want us to do more. We already know that. But I'm telling you, when we do more, we get banned. We get banned. We get in trouble. Y'all don't want us in trouble, right? Y'all want us to keep doing good things. Y'all want us to stay on the air, right? Y'all don't want us getting blocked in your country. We got a lot of shows, but we just try to be cool, man. We're trying to be cool. Y'all have to understand that. Because it's hard to have high viewership when you blocked. So you got to try to get our viewership up and try not to make no enemies, even though we know that they're watching us. And they have to know that we know that they're watching us. And if they don't, I mean, well, boo-boo, bad job by y'all. But it is what it is, though. You know, watch us, because we want you to watch us, and we want you to understand what's going on, because we're speaking about what's going on and having fun while doing it. Man, Los Angeles is like the capital of crazy. So, man, we fucking it up here. Ain't nothing going to change. We're going to keep pushing. Dark Skies Podcast. And, hey, you're listening Thank you for listening. And we're having fun. Light them if you got them. We pushing, y'all. World Series is here.
I must have a $250,000 on me right now. Hard to make a song about something other than the money. Two things I'm about to talk and blunt and staying blunt. Pretty women, are you here? Are you here right now, huh? We should all disappear right now. Look, you're getting all your friends and you're getting in the car and you're coming to the house. Are we clear right now, huh? You see the fleet, all the new things. Cop cars with the loose change. All white like a mood things. Niggas see me rolling and they mood change. Like a motherfucker. New floor, I got a dozen of them. I don't trust you, you are undercover. I could probably make some steps, sisters fuck each other. Woo! Talking fillets with the truffle butter. Fresh sheets and towels, man, she gotta love it. Yeah, they all get what they desire from it. What? Tell them niggas we ain't hiding from it.
I'm still the highest selling female rapper for the record. Man, this is 65 million single soul. I ain't gotta compete with a single soul. I'm good with the ballpoint game, finger roll. Ask me how to do it, I don't tell a single soul. Pretty women, what's up? Is your hair right now? You a stand up or is you in your chair right now? Do you hear me? I can't let a whack nigga get near me. I might kiss the baddest bitch if you damn it. I ain't never need a man to take care of me. Yo, I'm in that big boy, bitches can't rent this. I floss every day, but I ain't a dentist. Your whole style and approach, I invented. And I ain't taking that back, cause I meant it.
Bank teller flirting after checking my account. Pretty ladies like, yeah. Truffle butter on your pussy. Cuddle buddies on the low. You ain't gotta tell your friend that I eat it in the morning. Cause she gon' say I know. Can I hit it in the bathroom? Put your hands on the toilet. I put one leg on the tub, girl. This my new dance move. I just don't know what to call it. But bitch, you dancing with the stars. I ain't nothing like your last dude. What's his name? Not important. I bought some cocaine, look, it's not air. She became a vacuum. Put it on my dick like carpet. Suck the white off white chocolate. I'm so heartless, thoughtless, lawless, and flawless, smallest, regardless, largest, and charging, born in New Orleans, get killed for Jordan, skateboard, I'm gnarly, Drake, Tunch, and Barbie, you know.
It's crazy how fast we're rising on this podcast thing. Man, this is Dark Skies Podcast in collaboration with Reckless Records, and the whole thing is just wild. But hey, as it grow, we're gonna grow. We're gonna keep having fun. Have fun with us. Hey, it's the weekend. We're in Los Angeles. It's live. We got championship games here. Word on the street. Green Bay here. What's up, Aaron Rodgers? Welcome home. It's on the cracking. You know what I'm saying? It's fun. But it's not just the sports, y'all. It's not just the sports. We got concerts going on. It's full. The whole plate.
Looking for revenge. All summer 16. Playing dirty, not clean. Out front for a season, looking like a damn football team. All in the same thing, all rapping one thing. Looking for revenge to do what you couldn't do. Tell Obama that my verses are just like the whips at the end. They bulletproof. Minus 20, we in Pitfield at K's Kitchen in the Canada Goose.
Fuck, goddamn it, fuck, but I'm still in the cup when they run up the truth.
I'm just a sicko, a real sicko when you get to know me, nigga. I let the diss record drop, you was staying right below me, nigga. We must have played it 100 times, you was going to bed. Why would I put on a vest? I expect you to aim for the head. I could have killed you the first time. You don't have to try and say it louder, nigga. Trust me, heard you the first time. It's nothing personal, I would have done it to anyone. And I blame where I came from.
And I blame all my day ones. You know chubs like Draymond. You better hope not say none. Them boys, they a handful. Then I hit them with the high line. Chris Breezy with the dance moves. Mo G with the dance moves. Ad Boy with the dance moves. Jimi Hendrix with the solo. Those are strings that you can't pull. Yeah, and I can really dish it out. Come and get it from the source. But fuck with all the word of mouth. Go to state running practice at my house, nigga. What am I about? You gon' really feel it now. I'm out here looking for revenge. All summer 16. All summer 16. Playing dirty, not clean. Out front for a season, looking like a damn football team. All repping one thing. Looking for revenge. All you boys in the new Toronto wanna be me a little. All your exes know I like my O's with a V in the middle. You would love it if I went away and didn't say nothing else. How am I keeping it real by keeping this shit to myself? You was never gang, 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 gang. You was never one of us. Had us fooled for a minute there, now we done all grown up. But I'm better off anyway. Y'all never gonna finish Drake. Say you see about it when you see me, man. Y'all never home anyway. Thought of things that you should've said. Said things that you shouldn't say. We even gave y'all the whole money play. And y'all broke to this day. Oh, it's your time now. Yeah, that's what everybody say. I used to wanna be on Rockefeller, then I turned into Jay. Now I got a house in LA, now I got a bigger pool than Ye. And look, man, Ye's pool is nice, mine's just bigger, is what I'm saying. I'm that nigga's what I'm saying. Getting things done around here, how you let me run it down here? I'm not even from around here. 6-6-6-6-6. Soon as I'm back in the city, they throw a parade. I might get a key to the city and give it to Wayne. Or give it to one of the young boys to carry the wave. Yeah. So trust me, they'll be out here looking for revenge. All summer 16, all summer 16. Playing dirty, not clean. Out front for a season, looking like a damn football team. All repping one thing, looking for revenge.
They don't want us to have a bigger pool than Kanye.
Yes, it's a full day, y'all. And we loving it. It's the weekend. We're live in Los Angeles. Whole squad is here. Man, having fun, having fun, having fun. I'm not stopping. But I tell you one thing, people. We're looking at it. We're looking at all of it. We got games. We got some of us. We got work. We got life. We got, you know, we got people we're trying to help. And, you know, we're not ignoring the big migration. And we got some shows coming up. Yeah, we know it's a lot going on in the world. You know, we just live here in Los Angeles, and Los Angeles just has so many distractions. And you gotta be on your toes, man. Just driving down the street could be dangerous. Yeah, in California, you can get killed walking your dog. Yes, indeed. And then they got these new scooters and stuff. Oh, man, don't get me started, man. Here in Los Angeles, man, they got this scooter program or what the hell is going on with these cats are riding around on these scooters. And, man, I'm not lying, man. It's crazy. You got to watch where you're going. But it is, I mean, it is wild. When you start to imagine I'm moving, you know, through time and space, right? And I'm trying to see what it's like to live day-to-day life. But then everything is so different and changes so quickly. You know, you got people riding around on bikes, right? You got the bike lanes, and then you got these new scooters riding around, and then you got these, you know, you just always got pedestrians and people that just randomly walk out into the street. You know, these people are not pedestrians. I just think they just people that just want to disrupt traffic. And they do. And it's just, wow, man, it's crazy. Just trying to maneuver throughout the city and, you know, get by. But it is what it is. We're going to keep doing what we're doing, and we're going to keep having fun while we're doing it. So, once again, light them if you got them. We're finna call it a day. Once again, I'm your host, LC Graves. We got Monty Nikes in the building. We got, hey, Jennifer and Becky in the Rising Twos. Jim helped out with the sound levels today. And as usual, the whole team works together. We work out of different studios. We worked out of Torrance. We worked out of L.A. We worked out of Manhattan Beach. We worked out of, Hollywood. So, you know, we worked out of different areas and continue to do so. Like I said, home base right here in Los Angeles. That's why every show we do is live from Los Angeles. So it is what it is. We'll be hitting you up a little bit later on. We have more content coming up. So, like we always promise, more shows. Okay, more shows are coming. But for now, thanks for joining us. You've been listening to Dark Skies Podcast, if you didn't know. But I think you know. And if you missed the show live, like I said, you can catch us on demand on Spreaker.com. Or you can catch past shows. Download them, listen to them at your own leisure. You can also catch us on YouTube as well as iHeartRadio. We're a growing platform and we're having fun, man. Catch us on Twitter, Facebook. Man, we're growing, folks. We're growing. So grow with us. Tell a friend, download us, share, retweet, and like. Man, I appreciate everything, people. I love you, and I'll talk to y'all very soon. Man, and thanks to the Green Lamp, we got this fire smoke. It's the weekend, folks. This is how we live. I'm out.